Yes, that is a Chinese hip-hop song about Karl Marx.
No life in the streets, huh? They can murder you on tape now. How I'm supposed to eat, huh? When my pockets getting raped, why? Officers oversee the demise of the family. Prisons are property. I'ma buy one and release me. That's the sound of your last dream. That's the sound of your dead son. How he only 12? But you saw him and he had a gun.
Japan's xenophobic tendencies are pretty much obvious anytime you're in Japan. Japanese people don't like anyone, right? We've known this for a very long time. They don't really bang with when people come in there and, you know, try and influence them at all, right? You've got Miss Japan, who people didn't want to even acknowledge as Japanese. She looks like, you know, somebody who could be related to me, but realistically, she's born in Japan, her mother's Japanese, she can't speak any other language other than Japanese. She was educated in the Japanese public school system.
Her father happened to be an American GI, or American soldier who was stationed in Japan. She won the Miss Japan competition, and then people lost their minds. They're like, she's not Japanese. It's like, well, how did she win the Miss Japan?
If she's not Japanese, you can only enter if you have a birth certificate that states you're Japanese.
And in Japan, the only way you can be Japanese is if your mother is Japanese. It's a weird distinction, right? Not your father, even though they are a patriarchal society. You literally have to come out a Japanese woman to be Japanese.
She did that. In Japan, right? In Japan, there's also this phenomenon of, Vice News calls it B-styling. Japanese people just, they don't really have a specific name for it. However, what they do like to do is take vestiges of 90s and early 2000s hip-hop culture and rock it. This woman has micro braids in. This woman is wearing a wig that was actually, she was proud of the fact that she bought it from America, even though ironically she could have just bought it from China, probably would have weighed less on the shipping, right? This guy's got cornrows, right? And this is Pinap. You can actually go to their Instagram and you can see. The only clothes that they sell are like this. Now, they have no concept. That's a Negro League baseball jersey. Now, in America, we try and kind of, we don't forget the Negro League, but we kind of do because it then reminds America of its super, super racist past, right? But here we go. They're rocking it. And again, last time, Ja Rule and Ashanti were, like, important. I was in middle school, so. All right. But hip-hop in Japan, how did it get here? Again, you've got the influence of pop culture spreading. Now, remember, Japan has pretty much, for about a 40-year period after, you know, the war of Japanese aggression in Asia, the American government came in and the American military basically said, you know what, and the UN co-signed and said, Japan, no more military for you. Matter of fact, no more anything for you. This is what you get to do. You can sit here and build robots and be clean. And that's kind of what they did. However, in terms of culture, right, a lot of the American GIs that were stationed there were bringing their own culture. So as hip-hop rose, and a lot of, in the past, the American military is based off of people who are genuinely indigent. So in China, right, the best people are in the military, right? It's your best, your brightest, right? No? Okay, well, that's kind of what they say. That's what they told me. In America, it's actually the opposite. It's the most poor, downtrodden people. The reason why they join the military is because they don't really have too many other skills. So this is a way for them to get educated. This is a way for them to travel, because America has military bases all over the world. It's a way for them to earn a living for their family. So the voice, again, that music that's providing a voice to the voiceless, is now being played on tape decks as those people go around different bases. It's being watched as the films come out, right? You've also got groups of Japanese breakdancers who are emerging because they've seen the movie Wild Style. You've got DJ Crush, who was the first Japanese DJ to use a turntable. And he also has toured with people like Malik B of The Roots, Mos Def, and A$AP Rock. Now, this is an interesting place, Club Harlem in Tokyo. Any you guys ever heard of it? Club Harlem is... and it's right next to Shibuya, which is like where you go if you want to have a great time in Tokyo. When you stand in the line, you notice that everybody going into Club Harlem looks like they came out of the 1980s. The only music that they play is hip-hop music, but foreigners cannot go in unless you work there. I've actually had 3 jobs DJing there, but there were no foreigner patrons. And at first I just thought, oh, maybe foreigners don't know about this place. They literally would not let my friends in. However, again, they're propagating a culture, right, that they're then not fully on board with. Then you've got these gentlemen in Yokohama. As we saw earlier, they were rapping about having 40 ounces and, you know, how hard it is to grow up in Yokohama. The average medium income in Yokohama per family is about 45,000 RMB per month. That means these people aren't necessarily poor. Not rich, but they're not poor. They're just doing this because, you know, with their bandanas and their baseball jerseys, because they just think it's cool, I guess. That hood idea. Then Vice did a documentary called Bad Hop, because these people were riding around telling you how crappy their lives were. The only reason why I know it's not is because I went there myself, and I was like, man, Yokohama's nicer than my neighborhood in D.C. Is that an aesthetic choice, or is that just, you know? Huh? Uh-huh. I don't have hair like, I mean, my man. Now, there's literally a song that came out 4 years before this song called Yup in My White Tee. I was literally copying a song that came from, he just Japanified it? I don't know, right? We've got Ko. He's a rapper who's moved to California. He started in Tokyo. He was the one rapping in the car in the opening segment. Ko is interesting because, again, now he lives in California, and he actually raps specifically in Japanese, but on American artist tracks. Also, you guys know Keith Ape, Ichima. He was featured on that song on the remix. So this is some street art I took a picture of while I was in Tokyo. I couldn't find anyone actively doing street art while I was in Tokyo and the greater Tokyo area. However, I saw street art places, so I don't know if that has anything to do with art or if it has anything to do with, you know, maybe an influence of hip-hop culture. But it looks cool, and it's a DJ, so. Now we're going to move on to South Korea. Now, South Korea's influence with foreigners has... we're going to focus on basically since the end of the Korean War. You've got now 2 Koreas, and now we're talking about South Korea. Again, the American military presence has helped exacerbate the influence of hip-hop, or just the influence of American culture. You've also got Koreans' complicated history with blackface. Blackface is, as you can see, that's a Korean person who painted their face black. It was used in America as a very hateful gesture, and still more or less is when it does come up. But since the 1970s, Korean blackface has been prominent on various game shows to I guess, mock whoever they think they're mocking. But even, it's not just that they're painting their face black, it's even got a wig, right? And again, whose hair is it trying to look like? Then you've also got the American media. The American media never, so in South Korea, they don't have the limited internet that, say, happens in China. They do have an influx of American media outlets that are there. When the Watts riots happened and the LA riots happened, you know, a lot of the businesses that were destroyed in those riots were of Korean Americans. However, the news outlets didn't give you the full context. Those riots happened for many reasons, and the reason why the businesses were destroyed that were Korean were because they were Korean businesses in black neighborhoods. Now, America has a very, again, complicated history with race and how economics are distributed, but the short version is black people couldn't set up black businesses in black neighborhoods, and then they couldn't set up black businesses outside. So when you're already frustrated at the system, what do? You take it out. A riot is the language of the oppressed, according to Dr. Martin Luther King. So the American media definitely showed these riots had happened over and over again on a nice little loop without context. And then to add fuel to the fire, Koreans don't, like, Koreans are very tied to the Korean-American community. They haven't really let it go. So now you've even got still an anti-almost black sentiment that exists within parts of South Korea. But then you've got people like this, right? The cohort. We have no idea what their knowledge of hip hop is, but as you can see, you saw them walking down the street. Again, well, you can't see because he's got the bucket hat, but he's definitely got some little locks or something going on. Bandanas on the face and on the head, right? The middle finger, this has no context outside of the United States, right? So clearly, this may be an example of appropriation. We've also got Keith Ape. Many of you all know. I saw you bobbing your heads when the song came on. You started singing along. It's great, right?
Have any of you guys heard of OG Macko? Yep. Not the people from America. Anyone else?
Again, we're going to talk about who influenced who. So, now, this song came out 2 years before Keith Ape ever made an appearance on the market. Now notice, he's not really necessarily rhyming. He's just, I guess you could say, almost a Tourette's attack over a record, right? However, we want to talk about a Tourette's attack over a record, right? Oversimplified beat, right? Minimal production.
Squash it. It's mine. I'm the water swap. You're dirty, mom and cat. Us. I see what you're working and bitch, you can't dress with us.
Even the videos, right? They're both just walking through hotels acting like idiots. I mean, I've had a night like this, but my point is, unnecessary graphics, images, you know. He's got his friends with him acting a fool again with a bottle of alcohol. My question is, where did he get his hair braided in China? Or actually, I'm sorry, in Korea. All right. You've also got CL, who has pretty much decided that she's going to be Nicki Minaj, Lil' Kim, Remy Ma, what's her name? Every female rapper all at one time. Well, the only reason why she's not Missy Elliott is because she has heels on, right? But realistically, she even looks like she might still, and she actually does dance in her videos, unlike, say, Lil' Kim or Nicki Minaj, right? They usually have dancers around them, right? But Missy Elliott used to actually do the dancing, right? And then they have this show in Korea called Unpretty Rap Star. So if you're a female rapper, you're not necessarily, you know, viewed as desirable, I guess. I don't know. That's what it translates. The words in Korean translate to Unpretty Rap Star. It's a show to find the next hip-hop talent of Korea, again, to put them into a group and still fashion them in a K-pop way, but again, like with a group dynamic, however, they are still rappers, right? So I'm